According as circumstances are favorable, one should modify one's plans. All warfare is based on deception. Hence, when able to attack, we must seem unable. When using our forces, we must seem inactive. When we are near, we must make the enemy believe we are far away. When far away, we must make him believe we are near. Hold out baits to entice the enemy. Feign disorder and crush him. If he is secure at all points, be prepared for him. If he is in superior strength, evade him. If your opponent is of choleric temper, seek to irritate him. Pretend to be weak, that he may yell at you. If he is taken, give him no rest. If his forces are united, separate from him.
And we are talking about games that cause polarizing opinion against explosives. This is our second episode dealing with games that cause polarizing opinions. Our first one was like, you know, 5 or 6 years ago. It's a long time ago. And people love to get into arguments, so this is like the perfect kind of episode for that, so you guys can battle on which game you like, which game you don't like. And of course, we love to read all the comments. Anyway, let's just get right on. Call of Duty Black Ops 3, developed by Treyarch and published by Activision in late 2015. You can pick any of the Call of Duty games, because every year, each entry causes polarizing opinions. But why did I pick this one, since there's so many other Call of Duty games? Well, that's simple. It was free! Believe it or not, some of the developers at Treyarch are fans of GameStack. They sent us a box of goodies from Black Ops 3, and each of us got a copy of the game that was signed by part of the development team. If that's not cool, then I don't know what is. Even if it wasn't free, I would have bought a copy of the game, as I'm a fan of the series, especially the Black Ops title. As everyone knows by now, this is a first-person shooter. The game has several modes of play, from a campaign mode to zombies to multiplayer deathmatch games and much more. The campaigns are always fun to me, as I actually like the stories that the characters follow. And to me, the best part is that the campaigns can usually be beaten in about 5 hours or so. In my mind, that's perfect, so I can get on with the other aspects of the game. Zombies is a nice side game where it's you and possibly a friend trying to survive wave after wave of zombie attacks. It's fun and it gets very challenging. This is a great mode to play on Halloween night. Or any night, actually. The big draw for the vast majority of the people who play this game, including me, is the online multiplayer. There's a whole laundry list of game modes that you can play, but I always have the most fun playing Team Deathmatch. I've actually lost track of time playing this mode in the past. Before I knew it, 4 or 5...
Contributing to maintain an army at a distance causes the people...
Errors have gone right. It feels like it was only a few moments.
On the other hand, the
multiplayer maps here are awesome. They're all interesting to play on. They feel very different from each other. People seem to always say that first-person shooter games are drab and full of bold colors, but not here. These maps are very colorful and really fun to just snoop around and look at all the details. The only constant is that you're killing and being killed. The controls have always been spot on, and if you're the one doing the killing, then it's something that you're doing. I know me is good at these games, but I really do enjoy playing them. This is a hard thing to talk about with you. In fact, since the only first-person shooter episode that we did was one of our least viewed, it's still under 40,000 views and it's almost 6 years old. So why does this game cause such polarizing opinions? You wouldn't think it would, given that this game was the best-selling software title of 2015. I mean, the game came out in November and still managed to claim the best-selling title for the entire year. Say that it's the same old thing year after year, and it's nothing new. Now, if you're talking about Madden football, I'd
Yourself.